before the internet, album art was one of the single biggest pushes to sell an album, especially in the world of metal.
Because you couldn't listen to the record, all you could do is stare at it and just go, well...
This is the visual art that the band or artist included with the music, and they want you to relate this to the songs that you're listening to.
There's no other form of music that's that connected with its imagery. So for me, growing up, a lot of times I bought stuff based off of the cover.
It just adds more to the music when you have something that can visually stimulate you as well as the audio.
I used to just sit with my record player and put the record on and just stare at the album cover, you know, just looking at it.
The first album that I really vividly remember the artwork was Van Halen's 1984. And just being like my mind was blown, you know?
It started with Shout the Devil, the pentagram, the fucking pentagram. It was such a powerful image.
When I'm listening to any song, even to this day, off the first Sabbath record, I have the color scheme of that record in my head. I think of pink.
Sometimes I wouldn't even like the album as much if the artwork, like for Judas Priest, it took me a while to get in a point of entry because I didn't like the cover.
If you do a bad shirt design, it, you know, it can fade into the distance and nobody would be the wiser. If you do a bad album design, that's always going to be in their discography. That's always going to pop up when it comes up with their name.
I bought Iron Maiden because of Derek Riggs' artwork. Not saying they're not a great band, but I think Iron Maiden got as big as they did because of Derek Riggs.
I knew who Cannibal Corpse were and I knew who Napalm Death were way before I ever heard their music, because metal dudes walking around my neighborhood would wear their merch, and like the art was so striking that it just made an impression.
So I'll go ahead and open up my music app right now to show you that most of my albums don't have album art. It just has that little default picture.
You know, now you shop on Amazon or you buy things in iTunes and the album cover is reduced to like a, you know, 1-inch by 1-inch mini.
It's possible you download a record illegally and you never even see the image.
The effect it has on your first impression is really a huge change.
I think mostly now it's something that goes at the top of a post on Metal Sucks or Metal Injection or whatever site you're reading when you read the announcement that the album is coming out.
I wonder, as a music fan myself, a lot of times, you know, shit, what use do you have for the artwork after you've already loaded it into your fucking computer?
Excuse me, do you know who I am?
I have absolutely no idea.
I'm embarrassed that I don't know who did the album art sometimes. I mean, there are guys out there where I recognize their style right away, but 99 times out of 100, I don't know who did it. And I would say 80 times out of 100, the press release makes no mention of who it was.
It drives me nuts when somebody puts a full page ad in Decibel with this image and the logo and all this stuff, and there's not even one thing at the bottom that says artwork by.
You know, if you think about it, there's more metal releases being put out today than ever before. And of course, there's album art that has to be produced for each one of those releases. But in a world where the bands are struggling to get noticed, you have to wonder, what about those artists?
It is important to put people's names on it, and it's important to pay them or compensate them in some way.
Most of the respectable bands do appreciate the artwork still and give credit to the artists.
Smart bands attribute their album art to the right people, and they know which artists to go for whatever visual aesthetic. And it's also kind of becoming part of, you know, they want to find the kind of celebrity artists to go along with their work.
I feel that the bands that do take the artwork on their albums seriously and take the artists that do their work for their album seriously are much more interesting bands.
And maybe in our world here, there lives a happy little mountain.
It's awesome that a band can truly control their art and have so many options available as to what they want to do. I personally like, you know, something that's more traditional, and I think a lot of that has made a comeback. You still see black and white hand-drawn album covers. You see somebody like Ed Repka has become such a legend in the scene that when a band comes out with his artwork, it's such a big deal.
It's just like metal itself. Everything's gotten progressively more extreme. Everything's gotten progressively a little bit sillier.
Obviously, when Photoshop came out in the early 90s, there was a sharp drop-off in quality across the board, not just in music, but in all sorts of publishing.
If you want to get stuff cheaper and get by, you can, you know, slap some skulls together and a buzzsaw and a couple things and make a metal cover.
It's a brilliant thing that we can have such a wide array of visual art to go along with such an evolving music scene.
So what does the future of art look like?
I think more elaborate packaging is probably on the way.
I guess what I hope for it is that it keeps print culture alive.
The great thing about metal fans in general is that they still embrace, you know, the analog, you know, they still want, you know, the CD or even more cases, the vinyl.
Seems like a lot of bands are focusing on album art again heavily because they want to sell a physical product, you know?
Your best chance for getting someone to actually buy it instead of download it is to make it worth having, to make it worth buying.
Album art is never going to be irrelevant because you still have to translate that into merch designs and whatever promotional material. If it's not going to be seen necessarily on an album cover, you're always going to see it on a shirt, you're always going to see it on a backdrop.
You're seeing, I think, a big collector's market with heavy metal artwork. We're seeing coffee table books come out. We're seeing like long form articles about artwork and heavy metal. We're seeing more merchandising than ever. You're seeing, you know, even mainstream acceptance of heavy metal artwork too. It's a part of all culture now. It's not just a part of like our subculture as it used to be.
I find every day somebody with a new Dillinger tattoo of our cover of our record, and that might be the first time someone saw the cover of our record, is they saw someone's tattoo of the cover of our record on Instagram or something like that. So it's just different. And I'm not sure if it's better or worse, but it's definitely different.